masked man here. Let me just briefly reveal Bob Bowles here. And I'm going to mask up again, as I hope all of you are masked watching this. This will all be, I think this is all windows. Most of this facade is going to be as many windows as possible, so it'll be a beautiful set of windows instead of a bricked off wall. So you can see into the lobby, very inviting. And so, let me take you through the inside of the theater, which, especially if you haven't seen it in a while, will look very different. So, shoot, the music is now muted. This, I hope you can see it well, it'll have a whole lot of natural light in here, is of course the lobby. This would have been the concession stand where I'm standing now. Obviously that is all gone. And when the old movie theater days, this used to be the box office. This was an enclosed space in the box office, which became the concession stand for TAP. And you look over on this side of the wall, you'll see again, more exposed brick. And right here, where this square opening is, up a section here, this is the new stand, will actually be a separate room that's where the door will be right here. And it will be just this nice, comfortable lounge space for our concession stand. So that is here. If we turn over here to where the box office formerly was, again, more exposed brick, a lot of brick in this place. This is going to be, this is our part of our lobby. This is going to be actually opened up, because next door we have in the old Advocate building our offices, and we're going to join the two buildings together, so it will expand the lobby. The new box office will be actually in the office space now. And so it'll be in this beautiful, lovely open space here. And look at the ceiling. All the old ceiling tiles are gone. And we have this rather rustic look. So I wanted to show this to you now, because the next time you see it, it'll look very different. We'll check back with you at various stages of the renovation. But I wanted this, they've pretty much, I don't know if they finished the demolition, but they've gotten quite a long way into it. And now we're gonna go into the main theater, the big room, which a lot of you probably are not used to seeing, because we do all of our plays, of course, in the back in the small studio theater space. But as you'll see in a moment, the two spaces are now basically one for the moment. So follow me into the theater. Giving these chairs away, stack pile. I'd rather them be used by people who will love and adore them. But you see this...
Okay.
Well, welcome back. We had a slight technical difficulty there, but we'll just consider this part two of the tour. So, as I was saying, we are going into the main theater right now. And you can see we had 250 seats in here about 2 months ago. And now we're down to what, I don't even know how many, but significantly less than that. In fact, if anybody would like to have a piece of Third Avenue Playhouse, one of these seats, please give us a call. We're giving them away. So, give you some idea of what is going to happen in the renovation here. I think from the entrance to the theater to approximately, I'm not sure exactly where, this will all be an enclosed space. The concession, the room with the concession stand will actually be coming out in this area here. And then we have other, like a storage space over there. But anyway, this will all be enclosed. And then we have 8 rows of seats planned, and they will be in an amphitheater-like setting. So they will all be raised up and curved toward the stage. So that ensures you should feel as intimate as a back room with 84 seats. We'll have 125 seats, but we have this wonderful intimate configuration of seats, a few more seats, much more comfortable seats, I might add, and we are committed to giving you the same personal intimate experience that you come to love and expect here at Third Avenue Playhouse. It'll just be in a much more, better and improved setting, certainly more comfortable. We have more ability to present things on the stage for you. And I cannot wait to work on it and to show it off. But so I believe the seating will start approximately here. And then, of course, go all the way down. So like I said, the seating will be on an upward slope.
Hold for a second. Okay, we're back.
Okay. And now, if you look where I'm looking, there used to be a wall here. And I'm going to walk back into what was the old studio theater. You may recognize it from such shows as. So this is going to become a scene shop space, so we can build sets, props, etc. It'll also have new dressing rooms for the actors, bathrooms and such for the actors. And, you know, it's one thing we haven't had here at Third Avenue Playhouse is room for a scene shop. We've actually used the big theater room to build sets in, which was a horrible waste of space. But it was the only space we had to do it. And as we'd be running a play here at the studio theater, and while that was running, we were building a set or rehearsing in the big room. And now we'll be building our sets back here, and I'll show you we have a new rehearsal space on the second floor. So it's all coming together really nicely. And we're using all the space in the building to its best advantage. And that's a really exciting thing to see. So let's just take a trip down memory lane here. And this is the studio theater where we have been presenting plays since June of 2012. Here's what's left of the seats that were bolted in. We had 6 rows. When we got here, James and I got here, this was used as primarily a storage area, some dressing room space, and we brought up the seats from the basement. We put in 6 rows here, and Portside Builders donated a stage that they built for us here, and we were off and running. And it feels a little, weird is not the right word, but maybe it is.
Bittersweet.
We spent a lot of time in this room, and we did a lot of good stuff in this room. Mm-hmm. And although I'm really happy for the upgrade and all this, this was a really special place to work and to see the work. And I'm getting flashes of just the very first, I remember the very first rehearsal in this room was where the subject was roses in June of 2012. And I remember we had our table set so we could read the play right here on stage. And I remember saying, I didn't rehearse this ahead of time because it didn't really hit me until that moment, said, this is the very first play very first rehearsal of the very first play here at the Third Avenue Playhouse. And it felt then like a very important moment. And it still feels that way, and even more so now. Because we felt in our own, our own little way, we were making some sort of history here. And we didn't know how long it was going to last. That could have been the only play we've done, But fortunately, because of people like you, we got to do a second one, and a third one, and a fourth, and a fifth, and on and on and on. So, as I tell people all the time, people tell us, how much they enjoy this place, and I say, look, as long as you keep coming, we'll keep doing it. Because if you stop coming, we'd just be doing it for ourselves, and that's not why we're here. Okay, so, like I said, this will be the new scene shop, dressing rooms. I think the dressing rooms are to my left, mm-hmm. I believe, mm-hmm. in that area. So, John Gannot, our new technical director, will have this lovely space to be his little sandbox where he can create all kinds of magic in here. And let's see, what else can we show you? Let's see. Well, one thing we will have in the new space, and I know this is going to be a delightful addition for many of you, I know it is for me, is great ventilation and heating and cooling. One problem with this back room was in the summer, the temperature in the room on the stage, because of the lights, made the actors, they got so incredibly hot. So to counteract that, we had to bump up the air conditioning in the house where the audience sits, and they froze to death. We had to give people blankets, sweaters or whatever, just to keep everybody comfortable. That will not be a problem in the new space at all. And I think the patrons will be delighted with the brand new bathrooms that we have. Bigger and better and newer bathrooms, or new, I mean newer. So here we are in a state of a very rustic demolition right now. These guys have been working like crazy, getting all this done, and it's amazing to see this place open up like this. Every day it was like looking at a brand new space, and they uncovered certain things here and there. Just so we can orient you maybe a little bit. The long hallway that you would walk down to get into the studio space is right over here, and we won't go in there because there's no light, but that just maybe orient you. Of course, we have all this exposed brick, which was never exposed before. And here is the entrance to the old space. Now, for those of you who didn't know, when this was a movie theater, the old space was actually built as an adjacent to the actual building itself. So it's in effect a separate building. So they built this hallway because the original movie theater, the wall extended to here, and they had many more seats because they could go up to where the screen was right here. So this was a much wider space when it was a movie theater. And you can really see that now. I've gotten so used to the hallway and the back room and all that, and now it seems like a much bigger building than I ever realized before. Do we have lights on the second floor?
I don't know. We could do that as a part three.
Yeah, we'll do this part three. What is going to happen? This renovation is scheduled to be done by April 1st. And we're doing things in phases. So the first phase is to complete the interior of the theater, the scene shop, and the dressing rooms, all that stuff back there, and the lobby, which public bathrooms there. The second phase, we have a second and third floor and stuff to do in the basement here, because we have a basement that's as big as this, you know, we have as much space below us as we do on top of us. So the second floor, which we will show you at a different time, is going to be our rehearsal space. It doubles as a conference room, a meeting room, if needed. Then we have the third floor, which before, you know, all the time we've been here, in this enormous heating and cooling unit that, I don't know, was built sometime in the Jurassic era, sometime after Shakespeare and before Oscar Wilde, somewhere in there. Old unit, and with all the utility bills that come with that. So that will be a thing of the past. But that took up a lot of space. It took up most of the third floor. And that is either coming out or it's already out.
It's gone.
And you'll notice there's also a remnant of that old unit on the roof of the building, which will also be gone away. So we have a lot of stuff to do. So basically that's it. That is the state of the Third Avenue Playhouse at this time. It's a very, very exciting thing to see this time that we're going through. I tell you, I tell people a lot, this has given us a huge shot in the arm, having this project to focus on while we're not able to produce theater. And we know when that day comes that we are able to get back up and running, we will have it in a brand new, beautiful facility, which is, can't tell you what that means. So April 1st is the scheduled date to finish this phase of the project. But between now and then, we'll check back in with the Facebook Live to give you updates on, you know, when the new seats come in, and, you know, little things as the place changes. But we wanted to make sure that you saw what it's like now. You know what it was like before, and it's all I can say is thank you to everybody that helped make this happen. Because, and I'm not just talking about people who donated to this renovation campaign at all, to everybody who has been showing up over the years. You've all made this happen. It would not happen without you. And I'm not taking away anything that I or James or Amy or John or any of the board members do. We've all done really Herculean work at times here. But like I said, it would all be for nothing if you didn't show up. So thanks for showing up. And so I will...
Well, we can let people know that more information is available at reimaginetap.com.
That voice you hear is Amy Frank, our wonderful managing director. So yes, more information is available at reimaginetap.com. It's reimaginetap.com.
Okay.
And give that a look. And thank you for taking the tour with me. How do you like the hat?
It's
and
good.
Wear your mask. Okay? Keep it over your nose, too. All right. Thanks a lot. So long.